G'day, Tibbs. How's it going? Well, how's she going today, Tubes? Pretty good here. It's nice and sunny finally. No rain, no freezing rain, no snow. Holy. And I guess we're going to start clean up on that big branch that fell off there. And chainsawing. So I got the strap on the head GoPro thing ready to rock. So you'll be able to see like the part, you know, when I'm sawing and stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and work on that today. And scored something pretty huge yesterday. Something I've been thinking of doing for a while over at the office there, because there's always an issue with whenever we get a lot of rain or something, the eaves troughs or whatever, they're not far enough away from the building, and they end up leaking a bit of water into the basement there on the floor and stuff, makes kind of a mess. So I picked up some freebie stuff yesterday there that we're gonna drill in eventually here. So basically, let's show you what we got. Free, yeah, like that kind, just had to go pick it up. And this is a drilled perforated one, which I guess is still all right. But and then we got a solid one here with another blue one there. Like these are, I guess, draining pipes or whatever, weeping pipes. And then there's let's put this down here for a sec. There's these blue ones for water, for clean water. And scored some more ones in here too. These were just in a garbage pile out of a new subdivision. So this is a nice big one here. Holy cow, that must be like one of the big mains or something. Huge main water in the next. This would be a runoff secondary one or something into the another street or whatever. And then we got another one, big one there. So what my idea was to, where the eaves trough comes out of the building, drill a, or dig a big hole down as far as I can and put one of those down so the water drains into there, drains down past the foundation, which should be around here or something, and then past that and then down into the groundwater, you know, water below that. So that's kind of the idea of what's gonna happen here. So I got some extra pipes too. I don't know if I'm gonna need all of these, but worst comes to worst, you know, I'll probably use this one. It's not super huge long, but it'll get down and rid of most of it, I think. So yeah, so that's the idea. It's gonna be I don't know, we're not doing that today, but one of these days. And then this one, I don't know, it was good until I seen the perforations drilled into it, and I thought, oh, that'd be perfect. And then I seen that, I'm like, oh no. So I guess I just drill these holes in them, and that lets the water go through the pipe and then out the pipe or whatever, you know. So but I'll show you that area I'm thinking of. And there's a couple of spots I'm gonna have to do, because I think there's three eaves troughs or something on that building. I can't really remember now. But anyways, let's head down and get our chainsaws and stuff all ready. We're going to chainsaw that tree bit up today there, and I'm gonna strap the GoPro on my head so you can see, like I say, that as I'm working. And yeah, so let's head her down. Shove these over there with the tractor.
I would put those over there, but they're big enough for what?
I'm not worried about it. I'm not cutting that bit off.
Yeah.
Nope. I didn't expect you to be back here. I'm almost done anyways. I'm not going to cut this up real small.
No.
I'll just take that up like that.
Yeah.
One more cut there, I think. Ah. And that figure. I'm out of gas.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Out of gas. Pain in the gas. I only got like one more cut left. Not too bad though. Cut all that up on one tank. You know, some pretty heavy duty cutting there, so. Okay, now it should be all